Hi everyone, today I'm going to show you how to make some tassels like this one here and pom-poms you can use to decorate anything you want. To make these, you only need a few simple items. Yarn, particularly for the pom-poms. This is called embroidery floss. You can find it at most craft stores. You can also use different types of string and thread for the tassel, that's up to you. And a fork. One last thing you'll need is a pair of scissors. Now these are fabric scissors, really good for cutting anything thread-wise. A regular scissors work as well as long as it can cut through. You won't need to cut too much, so that will be useful. All right, let's get to it.
Okay, I'm gonna show you how to make a tassel first. So first off, we're going to pull out a little piece of the embroidery thread we have. Just cut it off. It only needs to be a few inches long. All right. Take our fork and line it up just along the top like that. Now, put this down for a minute. I like to unfurl some of the embroidery thread, which makes it easier to work with. Okay, back to the beginning point. Pick up a fork again. And just like that, I'm going to start just winding around and around. Keep that end up. If you have it going a little while, go faster. So you want to keep them grouped together as much as possible. The more thread you use, the thicker the tassel is going to be, the less, the smaller it's going to be. That looks good for me. I'm just gonna snip off the end. Just be gentle, it can get gnawed a little bit, but be okay. And again, take another little piece. It's good. If you're worried, just do it the length of your fork. Okay. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this and I'm gonna feed it through this top space here. Make sure this top one stays up here, out of the way. Flip the fork over. Here on the back, I'm going to tie this thread up nice and tight. I want to pull too tight because you don't want to break the thread. Pull it off and just tighten it a little bit more. Make sure you double knot it. That way it'll stay and won't come undone. There you go. So to finish this off, take your scissors here, just put it through the bottom part. See here, you have the smaller end, which is the top. Just cut the bottom. All right, and go to the back. And just trim off these pieces I used to tie it. Doesn't have to be perfect, just as long as it makes it smaller, it'll hide it away. And I'm going to take it all down. Just give it a nice, quick trim. There you go. If you need to, you can work with it. See this piece stuck, kind of sticking out. If you wet it a little bit, it should fold back down. If not, you can just cut it out. Now, this piece that we attached at the beginning, You don't actually need to use this piece here, but it does provide you with the ability to just create a loop and tie this to whatever you want to use. Right? Now I'm going to show you how to make a pom-pom using the same fork and scissors and yarn instead of embroidery thread. First off, you're going to want to take a piece of the yarn and cut it off. Something roughly the size of the fork will work, similar to the tassel. This time you're going to place it through the middle of the fork, as you see here, and just kind of hold it off to the side. And take your yarn, just start at the top and just keep winding it around. You're gonna try to build it up in one section, go the length of the fork, and just keep going around. You're gonna need quite a bit more yarn than you did with the tassel. Can see you're just gonna keep going. Fill up the fork as best you can. Keep an eye on the end of the fork because it could start to come off a bit as it goes. Make sure it all stays on. Check it as you go. You want to give it like a nice width on the fork. You see, some of it came off on mine. Just kind of push it back down. Feel free to really squeeze it in tight again. Press it back down as you work. There you go. Just wind it around some more. You can see here it got really thick around the fork, and that's what you want to aim for, something very substantial. Just cut off the end and take the piece you cut off at the beginning and tie it off in the middle. Again, you want to make it tight, but don't pull too tight because you don't want to break the yarn. Take it off the fork and tighten it up a bit more. You can see it starts to make a full shape there and closing off. And again, you want to double knot it to make sure it's secure. Have a look at it. And now you want to take your fabric scissors and cut open the loops on both ends. Don't worry about taking too much at one time to cut. Just work your way around it, cutting the loops open a little at a time can work best. Just go around. You're gonna have to go through a couple of layers, is what really gives it its volume. And you can alternate from one side to the other. You don't have to finish one side first. This can kind of help make it a bit more even when it opens as well. There you go. Just keep cutting. This could take a little while to get it all open. Once you get to a point, you can just fluff it open a little bit so you can get to the ones underneath. There you go. There's one in the middle that I missed. You can check for and cut that open. Once you get it all cut open, it'll look a little off. You can see the shape is kind of oval and pieces are sticking out. That's fine. The two pieces you used to tie it shut, you want to keep those aside and make sure not to cut them right now. So you hold on to them, keep them safe, and then just take your fabric scissors and trim the pom-pom. Trim off the straggling pieces. And just shape it into that circular ball. It's very familiar. Just keep going around. You can go back in and make it a little bit smaller, whatever size and shape you want. And it's good to do this over a table because you can see all the little pieces of the yarn that starts getting trimmed off can be a little bit messy. It's easier to clean off of a solid surface. Again, make sure not to cut those two long pieces of yarn. You can take a little while to trim it. Take your time, take a look at it. Make sure you like the way it's starting to look. Shaping it can be as detailed or simple as you want. It's up to you. You can see I'm taking my time going around, cleaning off all those little dust pieces from the yarn. And there you go. You can see the pom-pom. Those two strings are how you'd attach it to many things. If you want, you can simply open up one of the pieces on the sides of it and glue it onto something like the pen cap if you want. Or you can take the strings and tie them off, creating a loop. You can attach it or hang your pom-pom from something, whatever you choose. If you want, you can also sew it on to a pillow or a garment. And those tassels, the long pieces, are what you'd use to attach it, what would actually get sewn or glued onto something.
There you go, it's that simple. Okay, so you can use these to decorate jewelry, my bracelet and my necklace here. You can use them to decorate pillows, the corners of pillows, it's always cute with some pom-poms on them. Pens, curtains, anything you want. Go to town. Fun, easy way to add a little bit of funky fun to your home decor, your work office, or anything else. All right, let's take one last look at these. Bye.